is Darian Humphreys, and here with me for the play-by-play is the man, the myth, the legend, player of the game himself, Bob Kensington White. Bob, how are you doing tonight, brother?
Well, I can't complain tonight. Doing fantastic, as usual. I was very excited last night that I was playing over the game.
We were excited for you. We saw that game. We saw that excellent fumble recovery for a touchdown. We saw the sack that you made. You had a very good game last night, Bob.
It was a fantastic game. There was only one little confusion last night because I didn't realize there was a penalty last night, and I still tackled the quarterback last night.
You did. We commented on that, so that was really awesome. But tonight we've got the Seahawks and the Mustangs. The Mustangs coming in with a record of 7-2, solidly in second place in their conference, and the Seahawks coming in with a perfect record as a result of some midseason shuffling with teams, coming in with a 9-0 record, leading their division as well. So, two teams at the head of their conferences tonight, when what looks like is going to be a really good showdown between two powerhouse teams. What do you think, Bob?
Yeah, this is really going to be a interesting game tonight. That's the way I am going to put it as to everybody.
Right. So, as we've been doing all week, we're going to start off this broadcast in this game by honoring one of our friends and fellow players who us, Ryrie Shackleton, who passed away, beloved by so many people in the league, wonderful competitor, and so we're going to take a moment to honor her with a moment of silence before the start of the game.
Hey, everybody. Real quick, we're going to do a moment of silence for Rari. She was well-liked and well-known in the community. Not only was she a teammate, but of a good friend, so at this point in time, we're going to take a moment of silence for her. All right, everybody, let's go ahead and get this show on the road.
Okay, you all, we're back now from the moment of silence. Like we said, she will be missed from the whole football community and hockey community.
Allow me a moment to correct myself. Forgive me, Mustangs. The Mustangs are coming in with a record. Coming in with a record of 8-1. I said earlier 7-2. They are 8-1. So, two powerhouse teams getting ready to square off. Looks like the Seahawks will be kicking. The Mustangs are set to receive. The Mustangs line up with Big Mike Turbo, Blaze Vella, and Kent Voss in the backfield.
I believe that was at the 20. No, hold on. That's at the 30-yard line, my mistake, you all. We're not able to see the announcers, so just bear with us a moment with this one. But the main rep, the okay, hold on for a second. That was a quarterback sack. Good job from the Seahawks for doing the quarterback sack. So if they can work on that one tonight, good job. You're containing that quarterback. That what you're doing tonight.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. The Mustangs are going to have to find a way to slow down that Seahawks front rush and buy Blaze enough time to make plays. Blaze dropping way back, gets the pass off. Looks like it's going to all incomplete, being up third down.
Yep, third and 10. That is what I can see.
Yeah.
So So he's going. Oh, hold, oh! Another quarterback sack. And
it looks like.
And by the way, all if you yeah, my dog is barking in the background, so just ignore that at this time.
All right. So after negative yardage plays on two of the three downs, the Mustangs are lined up to punt. The Seahawks have Jazzy and Chris Taco in the back to receive. Looks like the ball is going to go out of bounds. Seahawks will take over on the 37-yard line. Seahawks lining up. They're led by Jazzy tonight at quarterback with Crevin, Lieutenant Dan, Chris Taco, Jaden Primetime, and Skinnerd. And the receiver spots, well, now we've got some shuffling around. We've got Alf on the line there with Primetime and Otis.
Okay, he's Jazzy is the quarterback, so she throwed it, and it's no good. Wow. Best of advice, hashtag Coach Bob at the service for a second. Do a short pass. That's going to help a lot.
All right, Jazzy rolling out to the right. She scrambles back. She goes to the left. She passes. She's got a receiver. Looks like Chris Taco there for the reception. Comes down, gaining 9 yards. Going to bring up third down. Oh, actually, it's going to be first down. So, big first down conversion there for the Seahawks. The ball is set hiked. Jazzy's going to scramble to the right. She's going to go back to the left. She's got plenty of time. She passes to the left cross field. It is picked up by Chris Taco again, who makes a move to the outside. He's got
oh,
to the
he's going! He's going! Trying to find 30! Oh, my gosh. Almost a touchdown, folks.
Yeah, the excellent play by Chris Taco there, Lieutenant Dan. Coming down with that reception and making it happen on his own, picking up big yards, bringing up first and goal from the 5-yard line. Jazzy's going to scramble. She shows run. She backs up and moves to the left. She looks like she's going to run, and she does. She crosses the line of scrimmage and is brought down by Kat Pierce-Vella after a gain of what looks like about one. So it's going to bring up.
Go ahead.
No. You go ahead. No,
okay. Yeah, only 1 yard? That's good to the extent, but do what my best advice is. Okay. Down. Two rules. Pass football. Do it, you go good. Okay, she's going, and
well,
it's a... Oh, no good. Actually, now I'm going to say it's a touchdown.
They listen to you. So Jazzy's go-to receiver, Chris Taco, bringing it down for the score. Maybe. We'll see what the field says. It looked like he was in.
I think they'll be viewing it at this time, as usual. Yeah, they always could be reviewing these plays to make sure if it's in. Actually, yep. So that was a touchdown, and this field goal will make it 7-0 at this time.
All right, so the Seahawks are lined up to kick. The kick is up. And good. So with 5 minutes, 59 seconds left to go in the first quarter, the Seahawks taking an early lead. Moving up 7-0 over the Mustangs. So, Bob, what do you think about the first drive for both of these teams?
Hard to say for a second, but sound like that the Seahawks are coming out strong in the early beginning of the game. So. She kicked it off to the Mustangs now. That's a wonderful kickoff. And now the Mustangs are going. Oh, wow. Hold on. Wow. Okay. So is that the 30-yard line? That's what I can assess to that.
Well, Blaze coming down with the reception. He's brought down at the 25-yard line, bringing it up first and 10. For the Mustangs, you've got Dexter, Scotty, and Staples on the left side, with Marlowe and Kent, the receivers on the right. Pass up.
Good catch.
Caught by Dexter. So a great start to the second drive by the Mustangs. Blaze getting off the quick pass to Dexter, who picks up the first down, bringing up first and 10 from the 47-yard
40,
line.
yeah, 47 or 48 at the latest. Okay, she, as what I'm saying, they, okay, hold on, look at that for a second. Okay, good catch, but best of advice, sweet deal, do not go all the way back like that. Okay, that's how they're going to sack you in the first place. You're going to use us a lot, you lose a lot of yards. Yes, it is a first down, I know, it is, but do not go all the way back. Go about in the middle of the line to go back, not that much, please.
Okay, so on this play, it looked like Blaze was trying to pick up the quick run, but the Seahawks were able to converge, and the play results in a loss of yardage, a loss of about a yard. So Blaze is going to hike the ball. He scrambles to his right, back to the left. He's got a lot of pressure. Jazzy is on him, and it looks like it's going to be bat down by Jazzy.
Wow.
So the Seahawks able to bring a lot of pressure early on Blaze. So the Mustangs here, if they're going to keep sustaining this drive, they're going to have to come up with an answer to slow down that rush by the Seahawks there, give Blaze time to make a play.
Yeah, make a good play, and then you're going to do well. If you're not going to make a good play, you won't do well. Okay, that is the most biggest mistake I ever seen yet. Okay, running all the way back to the 30-yard line? Oh, come on. But now that was a interception, and the Mustangs, I mean the Seahawks has the ball now. See, first mistake ever. Do not run to the 30-yard line. Just don't.
All right, so Jazzy's going to scramble. She's going to cross the line, picks up a couple of yards, but she's brought down, looks like, by Cat again. So it looks like it is going to be second down and 7 yards. I apologize for the imprecise calls there. We're kind of far back from the field there, so it's kind of hard to tell yardage and such. But second down, Jazzy's going to scramble to her left. She's got plenty of time. Excellent blocking up front by the Seahawks. Scrambling, looking for a receiver downfield. She passes the ball. It is intercepted by Staples. Oh my God, go!
45! Wow! Wow! Fantastic job for the Mustangs! Congratulations! Almost a touchdown right there. Good job. That's what I was
So,
talking about.
just like that, the Mustangs able to capitalize on an interception by Staples Price, bringing it all the way down to the 4-yard line, bringing up first and goal for the Mustangs here. So great
Wow.
turnaround by the Mustangs here. Let's see if they're able to capitalize. Blaze hikes the ball. He scrambles back deep. He's got a lot of pressure on him. Looking for a receiver. He throws it
No
and
good.
throws it out of bounds. That actually looks like it may end up resulting in a penalty there. Intentional grounding. The ball did not cross the line of scrimmage there. So looks like they're going to get flagged on the play for that one. So again, we see the Seahawks bringing in a lot of pressure, a lot of pursuit, not giving Blaze enough time to really look downfield for a connection. Really didn't have a running lane either. So the Mustangs, they're in great field position here. It looks like, barring a turnover, they are going to come away with some points here, at least a field goal. But that Mustangs front line are going to have to find a way, like I said before, of slowing down that rush. The Seahawks on defense, you have Lieutenant Dan in prime time in your DE spots. Odith and Jazzy at those outside linebacker positions have been putting a lot of pressure on Blaze at the moment. You've got Crevin and Dante, Chris Taco, and Skinnard in your secondary.
Yeah, I'm getting up the standings for the Mustangs at this time. I'm guessing the penalty is still being assessed by the referees. That's my only guess, because the Mustang have, because the Mustangs is on the ball, but not the Mustangs, so not. Seahawks are on, Mustangs not. So, that's what we are doing, folks. We're just waiting and seeing what's going on by the referees. Your referee is Horns, Monday, Montana. And the other one is Wino. And what I'm looking at, Wino is your main referee tonight.
Loss of down on the play.
Yep, you're absolutely correct on this one. Wonder why it's taking them that long just to assess that penalty like that.
Well, depending on the angle that the referees had, they probably had to go and look at the replay and see exactly where the ball went out of bounds. My camera angle was on Blaze, so I had a pretty good shot, but, you know, not being down there on the field, the referees needed to board before they made the call. So, you know, good diligent work there by the referees to spot that and make the proper call there. So that's going to set the Mustangs back, leave 10 yards, yep. And a loss of down. So that's going to bring up a third down, I believe, for the Mustangs.
Okay, I just checked the standings. The Seahawks are in fourth place in the division at this time. 9-0. So basically, if the Seahawks want to keep up with their order for a sec, the quarterback is going, and it's...
Interception!
And that's a touchback. Thank you. Okay, that's what I was saying. If the Seahawks wants to keep up in the standings, fourth place, okay... Do well, okay, to be 10-0 of the season. Do well. Actually, yeah, they're 9-0. Yeah, okay. 9-0, do well, play hard, work on some good plays tonight.
Absolutely. So an unfortunate turn of events. After the big interception by the Mustangs, they turn it over in the end zone. Jazzy's going to scramble. She's going to throw a cross field. She's got a receiver.
That's good.
It is caught.
Wow. Look at. Hold on. Good job.
But after a little bit of dancing around there, Chris Taco is brought down finally at the 44-yard line. So a gain of 24 yards on the play, bringing up first and 10 from the 44. Chris Taco is really Jazzy's favorite receiver tonight. I don't think so that she's thrown to anybody else yet. I'm the Mustangs, I might want to look at what to do to kind of get in the way of that connection there. The pass is up.
And
cross
it's
field.
Good.
And just like that, and look at him go!
Touchdown, Seahawks!
This time, Skinner bringing it down for the touchdown. So great, great play there. Jazzy mixing it up, finding Lieutenant Dan Skinner Sky Tower on the crossfield pass. And he does the rest, taking it in to extend the Seahawks lead to 13, pinning the extra point. Kick is up and good. So with 2:35 in the first quarter, after a couple of turnovers by both teams, the Seahawks take the lead at 14-0. So, you know, unfortunate couple of drives there for the Mustangs. You know, this game is far from over, but they're going to have to find a way to move the ball a little bit more effectively and keep the ball out of the hands of the Seahawks. Looked like they were poised to put some points on the board. But unfortunately, it didn't work out that way. So this drive is going to be crucial for the Mustangs if they want to stay in this game. The Seahawks is not a team that you really want to give a lead to like this early in the game.
Yeah, not in this early of the game, though. Okay. Short passes. Okay. Do not run all the way back. Run halfway. That's the second thing. Okay. Try not to get sacked. Quarterback. And by the way, folks, I just jinxed it. That's a quarterback sack. Sorry, y'all.
Yeah, Blaze making some moves. Looked like he was going to break away for a second, but ended up running into the back of one of his players, getting body checked, giving the defense time to catch up. And
another quarterback sack. And if they get one, another quarterback sack at the end zone, that would be a safety. So they better throw the ball now. Okay, just do something correct.
Deep pass up. It looks like
it's intercepted. Yep.
Couldn't tell. Looked like it was Dante in on the interception there. So a dangerous pass thrown, and unfortunately the Seahawks come down with it. So they are going to take the ball at the 47-yard line. Wallace Height, Jazzy scrambles. She rolls out to the left looking for a receiver downfield. The pass is up.
And it
is caught. And he could go.
Jaden this time. Touchdown! Seahawks! Come back.
So just like that, the Seahawks off of the turnover off from the interception put 6 more points on the board and are poised to take a commanding 21-0 lead late in the first quarter.
Yep, wait in the... Yeah, and there's only 1 minute left in the fourth quarter, folks. So listen to this, okay? There's still plenty of action going to go on, okay? We're still in the full staff, okay? Wait to see all the more excitement because it's not over until the fat lady sings.
Right, so with 1:16 left to go in the first quarter, the Seahawks putting up 3 unanswered touchdowns, bringing the score to 21-0. Blaze is going to take the kickoff. He's going to cross the 20, make a move, and is brought down at the 23-yard line. So the Mustangs in a must-do scenario here. The Mustangs front line, Veronica, Mikey, and Kat are going to have to come up with something to give Blaze a little bit more time. And his receivers are going to have to give him some help, you know, start running a little bit more of those comeback routes, some shorter routes, allowing Blaze to get the ball off a little bit quicker. The ball is up,
and
looks
it's
like
no
it's
good.
Going to fall incomplete.
So see, okay, good job on the throw, but make sure one of your own team catch the ball, okay? That can be your ultimate mistake right there, because... hold on for a sec, folks. See, quarterback is going right now, and it's still down. Good.
Yeah, Blaze finding a running lane, crosses the line, but only picks up a couple yards as the Seahawks were able to catch it there. So, bringing up 3rd and about 8.
Yep, 3rd and 8, and he better watch out or he's going to get sacked. Oh my god, what are you?
Oh
my gosh. Okay, now that is the most bad mistake you have done. Why are you running that far back again? Don't do that, okay? You'll just cost your team a whole yard to make up.
Bounce.
Don't ever do that. And the punter, and he just punted the ball, and it's going to be caught. And it's down at the 20-yard line. So, Daryl, what does the Seahawks have to do to keep scoring down these touchdowns? Okay, I'm guessing he's not there for a second, folks. Sorry about that.
No, I'm right here. Well, you know, if you're the Seahawks, you just keep doing what you're doing. You know, so far they've been very effective in the passing game. The Mustangs have not really come up with an answer to stop them. You know, right there we see Jazzy with the big 10-yard scramble there to pick up the first down. So if you're the Seahawks, you know, you just keep doing what you're doing. And, you know, stick to your game plan until they stop you and make you do something else.
You're absolutely right on that one. Sorry about that, folks. You got to do good, okay? If you do not do good, you know what's going to happen next, okay? You are going to get sacked. You're going to get, you're going to lose some yard on this, on the play. And that's good. Seahawks is...
He makes a move!
25 touchdown, Seahawks! Bam! Okay, folks, Seahawks got a fabulous touchdown, and the score is 28-0.
27, pending the kick here.
Yeah, no, it's always going to be good, so. For that, it's good.
All right. So, with 7:50 in the half, the Seahawks taking a commanding 4-score lead, bringing the score up to 28 to the Mustangs 0. And if you're the Mustangs right now, you've got to be scratching your head. You know, I imagine their team speak chatter is probably pretty animated right now. They're going to have to come up with some kind of way to answer the Seahawks' defensive attack. You know, that's really what's been hurting the Mustangs up to this point. They haven't found an answer for that front four rush. Blaze has had to drop back. He has had to scramble and make moves and really hasn't had time to get anything going. So we'll see what they come up with on this drive as Kent catches the kickoff return, runs up, and is brought down at the 33-yard line. So that's where the Mustangs will take over.
Yes, that's where the Mustangs are taking over tonight, folks. Yeah. So, they got to do good. And try not... That is another quarterback sack. Come on. Okay, stop with these quarterback sacks. Okay, the Seahawks are doing good. Okay, if you want to be a fantastic quarterback, learn how to throw the ball or pass it. That's what you got to do.
Blaze scrambles, drops back, tries to get the pass off, but Jazzy is there for another sack. Big losses there. Brings down Blaze at the 8-yard line. So the Mustangs again find themselves moving backwards. Blaze not able to get time off to get the pass downfield. So third and about a country mile here to go for the Mustangs. Blaze hikes the ball. He scrambles to the left. He's looking downfield. He's being pursued by
Otis. You better be careful. Be careful. Don't. Oh, my God.
And
gosh.
That's going to be a
safety. Okay. A safety. Seriously. Okay. If I was the Mustangs, I would be changing the quarterback. Okay. No offense. Your quarterback sucks right now. It does. Yes, folks, this is what I said, okay? You are keep on running back. Why do you want to do that, okay? Why? Do not run all the way back and get that bad.
Go ahead. If I can.
Sounds sad.
You know, you gotta look at the bigger picture here. You know, it's really... You can't really put your finger on one person at this point, you know? You know, is Blaze dropping back really far? Yes. But, I mean, if you look at it, he's been under a lot of pressure. The Seahawks front four, they've done a great job at dissecting the offensive line of the Mustangs there. So, you know, he's trying to make some plays happen, but it's really going to be a team effort to kind of turn this thing around at this point. To say that it's all on the QB, you know, it's a little bit unfair at this point. You know, it's just everybody really needs to kind of step up, and wow, what a connection.
25-30, touchdown, Seahawks. Boom.
Yeah, and that was just a great, great pass by Jazzy, who caught Skinner there in stride, and, you know, Skinner managed to get behind the secondary, and nobody was there to stop him. So, huge connection there for the Seahawks.
Yeah.
So the kick is up and is good. So with 6:16 left in the half, the Seahawks, rather, are running away with this one. The score is going to be 37-0 at this point. So, you know, frustrating outing for the Mustangs so far. You know, there's still a lot of football left to go, but the Mustangs are going to have to make some quick adjustments and find a little bit more success on the offensive front there if they have a shot to get back in this game.
Yeah, let me just fix one mistake while I said about their quarterback, okay? He don't suck. He needs to learn how to throw the ball better. That's what I have to say.
You heard the man. All right, so the Mustangs are going to take over at the 33-yard line.
Yeah, 33-yard line, folks. Down. So, look at this again, okay? Okay, is it me? Or is he actually listening to what I'm trying to say? That's what I think he's trying to do now, folks.
Well, Blaze there finding a running lane and picking up a good chunk of yards there, picking up 7 yards on the play. You know, and that's the kind of thing that you need to see from the Mustangs there. Blaze is one of the better runners in the league. Throws the ball downfield, but it is intercepted.
Ooh, yeah, interception.
By Jaden there. So another turnover on offense, and the Seahawks again come up with the interception. This time starting from the 25-yard line.
Down set. Yeah, 25-yard line. Okay, so see, Jazzy is doing a fantastic job out there. I'm impressed. Pretty Amber Jazzy tonight, okay? She used to be on the Raiders. She was a fantastic player. She really was. I have nothing to say anything about that. She really was, okay? It's really sad of us to see her go to a different team. I am glad that I'm seeing a good success out of her tonight. So that's
quick pass out to Dante, who picks up the first down and a little bit more, is finally brought down at the 43-yard line. So the Seahawks again moving ahead, seemingly at will at this point. The Mustangs really have not come up with an answer defensively to stop or slow down the Seahawks' offensive attack.
Down set.
Sorry about that, folks. I have some gas from mouth area. Yeah.
Well, there we go. Big stop. Oh. Staples Price with the big sack there on Jazzy. So just when we say it, you know, there's a big play there by the Mustangs, and that's exactly what they need to do.
Yeah.
Getting pressure on Jazzy, getting the Seahawks to move backwards there. So great play by Stapes.
Yeah, great. And that's a – what? Hold on. Okay, it's all good. I was just trying to make sure on something. So, excuse me again. So, you guys work together, okay, as what the Seahawks are doing. The Mustangs all work together, but the quarterback has to do a better job at throwing the ball. Throw the ball, not too far down, do not go all the way back. Go all the way back again. You're going to get another quarterback sack. Don't allow that. Okay. Work together. Okay. This is a team. Teams work together, you know.
And as he's scrambling to the right, rolls back to the
and
left.
That's good. And he's going. Oh, my gosh, folks. Oh, my golly. Okay. That's at the 10-yard line near the goalpost.
Jaden's spot with the reception that time. He's brought down at the 21-yard line, so it's going to bring up first and 10 there. And the Seahawks, again, threatening to score. Big
and
pass up.
Good job. Good catch.
Yeah, that was a great catch by Skinner. The pass thrown in coverage. Coverage was good. It was right there, but Skinner able to come down with it, bringing up first and goal from the 5-yard line for the Seahawks. And the Seahawks are threatening to break this wide open at this point.
And very soon it would be the – no, actually not yet, but – and that's – no. no good.
What's going on? A little bit of lag on the field there. Looks like the pass fell incomplete. Second and goal again from the 5-yard line.
Down set.
Ow, Twitch. Oh, I didn't. That's quarterback sack, folks.
And Veronica with a big sack on the play there, pushing the Seahawks back.
I didn't know that you can do a Twitch on the field like that, to be honest.
Down set height.
Okay, Jazzy's off. She's off. She's going to throw it. And oh my gosh, false and goal.
I believe Skinner was in for the well. Ball showing that he was brought down. It looked from my position that he actually got across the goal line on momentum, but we'll see if the play is going to stand as is. If it does, it's going to be fourth and one. Fourth and goal, rather, excuse me. And it looks like it's going to stand.
Yep.
Jassy's going to scramble to the right. She's looking at the receiver. Quick pass.
Okay, yeah, that's a touchdown, Seahawks. Okay, great job. There's only one correction I should just make on this one. Okay. I know you want to throw the ball. Okay, sometimes it can miss, sometimes it won't. Next time, do this. Wonderful, just run it, okay? One way or another, you're still going to get a touchdown like that. Run it down the field. Good job.
Down set. Height.
And the kick is good.
All right, so with a minute and 10 seconds left to go in the half, the Seahawks move ahead to 43. The Mustangs remain scoreless at this point.
Yeah. The Mustangs remain scoreless at this time, folks. So, what's going to happen? Are they going to wake up and actually score a touchdown? Well, this is what I really do think tonight. Okay. I'm guessing they still think that they're assuming they'll already break. That's what I really think tonight, folks. Okay. If you think that you still in the holiday break, the holiday break is way past over now. It just is. Okay. Well, next Monday is Martin Luther King anyway, do something good tonight, please. Actually, you are going to do something good. I know you will. Throw the football. And the quarterback did a fantastic job. He ran the football down the field. And it's second and...
five.
Second and five.
Yeah.
So now the quarterback is going. And perfect cat. Oh, no catch. Oops. See that, folks? That's how I caught myself on this one. Okay, if you can think that's he got a catch. Unfortunately, no. Okay.
Down.
The pass was intended incomplete on this one. And oh my gosh, folks, the quarterback is actually running down the field. You are now waking up. Good job. Wake up, smell the roses, score a touchdown. Go all the way.
Blaze doing what he does best there, like getting it done on his feet there. Picks up some good yardage there. He's scrambling back this play, and he's brought down just before he can get the ball off by Jazzy with another sack there. So moving the Mustangs back in the wrong direction, and it looks like the play clock is going to run out. That's going to bring us to halftime.
Now, folks, there was one special request from the Mustangs tonight, okay? In honor of Wiley tonight, okay? Please switch your viewers, okay, to midnight. For a fantastic show for the Mustangs tonight. Thank you.
All right, and before we switch over to the halftime show, I'd like to take a moment just to tell you about some of our fantastic sponsors without whom it would be very difficult to bring football to you in Second Life. We are sponsored by Blueberry. Blueberry is an original clothing store for women made by a woman with a passion for art. That is Blueberry. Simply Epic. Simply Epic is your one-stop shop for all your sports fan gear. Get football, baseball, basketball, or hockey, we have your team. Jerseys, hoodies, gotcha, and more. Don't see your favorite player or college team? Contact Eric Nabalo, and he will up in simply epic fashion. That is epic. It, girls and fellas. Need to surprise your friend with a res day gift? Need something extra to make your proposal extra special? Or are you looking to open your own club or mall? Maybe you just want to entertain and have some fun. Then why not hire the It Girls and Fellas, a professional dance troupe that always has fresh ideas for that perfect moment and regular off-Broadway shows at our beautiful Second Life Theater. For more information, contact Winsong Charming or Carrie Bella Velez for details. We are also sponsored by Glamorous. Glamorous was first established in December of 2013 and has since relaunched in April of 2014. Bringing poses from couples, adult, friends, kids, family, singles, gotchas, props, and much more. That is Glamorous. Rain. Shoes. Shoes. Rain is the go-to store for a woman with many styles. We have a variety of shoes and accessories to fit any occasion. Strive to make sure that everyone finds something that suits them. That is Rain. B-Fly Tattoos. B-Fly Tattoos has been creating in Second Life for over 5 years and is well known for the quality of work and customer service. With over 200 tattoos in store for both men and women and custom tattoos made to order, you are sure to find a design that suits your style. All tattoos come with the latest suppliers for mesh bodies for both men and women. They come in two tones and have a vast range from the very delicate to the over-the-top full-body designs. From abstract to oriental, from old school to new school, or custom made, B-Fly Tattoos has you in. And finally, I'd like to tell you about Femeshed. Femeshed is a monthly event that opens on the first of every month. Each month, we provide top quality original mesh designers to help fill your needs for fashion and home garden designers. We aim to provide the best of the best for the shoppers of Second Life. That is Femeshed. And with that, we are going to turn it over to the Mustang Darlings. Once again, those of you in attendance, the Mustang Darlings require or request that you switch your viewers to a midnight setting so that you're able to see the show in its full effect. So without further ado, we'll turn it over and we'll see you after the halftime.
Sound muted.
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero.
The Mustang Darlings would like to dedicate this performance to Ryrie Shackleton Pierce, number 23 from the Bulldogs. This one's for you, Peanut.
I'll be on my own.
feeling frightened of the things that I don't know. When tomorrow comes, tomorrow comes, tomorrow comes. And though the road is long, I look up to the sky, and in the dark I found, I thought that I won't fly. And I sing along, I sing along, then I sing along.
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero.
Believe that when you need that, I'll provide that. You will always have it.
Sound resumed.
Okay, folks, we are back. What a perfect halftime show from both teams. Okay, we're going to see if the teams are coming back up on the field now. And we're ready to begin our second half of the game. Seahawks 44 to nothing.
Yeah, excellent shows by both halftime squads. Thank you so much, and thank you to the Mustang Darlings for that special dedication to Ryrie. I know that our friends and family really appreciate it. Thank you for your thoughtfulness in that. So back to the game. Like you said, Bob, the Seahawks with a 44-0 lead over the Mustangs going into the third quarter. The Mustangs having an opportunity to regroup during the halftime. Hopefully they were able to talk some things out, and we'll see what adjustments they're going to be making here second half. On the other side of the field, the Seahawks, you know, all systems go. You know, everything has been working for them really well. Everything's been clicking. Their passing game has been phenomenal. So I'd expect to see the more of the same. It goes, again, back to that old philosophy. Do it until they stop you. So I expect to see more of the same from the Seahawks. As a reminder, before we get into the second half, if you're interested in helping out with the UFL, we're always looking for people to help us with our various operations. We have critical needs at both the referee positions and photographers. If you're interested...
Hold on for a sec, Dolphy, okay? It's at the 40-yard line with a good run of the ball. Good.
Absolutely. We have a critical need for photographers, so if you are a photographer and are interested in being a photographer for the UFL, please contact Dutchess Button. If you're interested in refereeing, please contact Raz McAndrews, Raz09 McAndrews. If you're interested in commentating, if you think you got what it takes, or if you're like me, if you have a face for radio, you can contact Wow, just lost.
I didn't know you had a feed for the radio. Come on.
Well.
Okay.
You can contact.
Okay, he's going. He's hold on for a sec, and it's good, and it's a force down Seahawks. Actually, hold on for a second. Yep, force down Seahawks. Good.
All right. Yeah. If you're interested in commentating, contact Matt Asadar, and we'll be more than happy to get you set up. As with streaming, we definitely have a strong need for streaming. If you have that technical know-how, please give Matt reach out to him because we need you desperately.
Yes, listen for me for one sec, okay? First of all, that's quarterback sack. We always need commentators, photography, streamers, and referees, okay? If you want to help out, please contact the visual people that, as what Dorland mentioned. Okay, Razden, referee, Duchess Button, photography, and Matt Sandal, streaming and commentating. Okay, we're in desperate need. Okay, if you want to send some awesome pictures, contact Duchess Button. She's awesome. Thank you.
All right, and the Mustangs coming up with a big defensive stop and a turnover off the interception. So they're going to get the ball back here at the 19-yard line. So we'll see what they're able to put together on offense and try and get some points on the board here. Blaze making a move, runs across the line of the scrimmage. He makes another move and is brought down after a 6-yard gain. So bringing up 2nd and 4 from the 30-yard line.
And
so Blaze again.
That's a good interception. And by the way, folks, I got I just checked for Facebook. I'm not going to mention any names. You know who you are that said it, that I am one of the best commentators ever. Thank you.
I am working in the presence of greatness, that is for sure. And the legend, Bob White. So, Blaze finding success with the passing game, passes across the middle, gains a good chunk of yardage, bringing up 1st down and 10. Blaze scrambles to his right, showing run, backs up, looks like he's looking downfield for the throw. He's under a lot of pressure, gets the pass off, and it is caught in the middle by, looks like, Dexter. So Dexter coming up with a clutch catch after a throw by Blaze under pressure and picking up another 1st down. So the Mustangs showing some signs of life here on offense, able to move the ball successfully so far. Lining up in a trips left formation, Blaze fakes right, scrambles to the left, looks like he's trying to run, gets the pass off to the
that's good. Oh, was that an interception?
I saw what he was looking at. He had Dexter along the sideline. He just didn't get enough air into the ball.
And that was an interception, folks. Man,
absolutely.
They had my heart pounding for about a second. I thought he was going to catch that ball.
As he scrambles to the left, she shows run, she backs up, she throws the ball, and it is caught by Jaden. Looking to gain some yards, he makes a move to the right. Picks up the 1st down, makes a move again,
Wow, good job.
Is finally brought down by, looks like, Cat. After an excellent gain on yards after catch there, bringing up 1st and 10 from the 39-yard line. But the Seahawks, again, able to move the ball down the field effectively, relying on their passing game to get it done.
Yeah, good. Wonder what? Okay. You're doing good. Okay. Both teams all doing good tonight.
Wide open receiver, Skinner makes
a
move.
25-30! Oh, my golly.
Yeah, and Jazzy had him wide open on that defensive right side there. Able to pick up some great yards after catch, bringing it down to the 12-yard line, bringing up 1st and 10 for the Seahawks from the 12. Jazzy's going to scramble to her right. She's going to move back to the left. She's
left
being pursued by Cat.
She's
gets the pass off and touchdown.
And down, Seahawks. Bam.
And that was Lieutenant Dan Chris Taco with the touchdown reception on that play. So pending the extra points, that is going to put the Seahawks up 51, Mustangs 0. Up and good. So with 4:14 left in the third, the Seahawks with a dominating performance so far with 51, and the Mustangs unable to put any points on the board up to this point. They did find some success moving down the field their last possession. Just unfortunate that it ended up in an interception, so we'll see if they're able to dial up this time and hopefully put some points on the board.
Yeah, hopefully. I know that the Mustangs are in desperate need of a point. Yes.
Blaze. Good. Blaze with an excellent return, coming close to midfield. He's brought down finally at the 38-yard line, so bringing up first and 10 from the 38. Good field position starting this opening drive here.
Yeah, good job.
Stumbled, looked like he was about to get away, but is finally brought down. The tackle is cleaned up, resulting in a big loss, another sack on the play for the Seahawks. And at this point, you know, if you're the Mustangs, you might need to start being a little bit forward thinking. Start looking at some things that you can develop going into the remainder of the season. Undoubtedly, the Mustangs are going to be in the playoffs. So, right now, just focusing on some fundamentals, focusing on some different things, trying some different works, might be what's in order here. They haven't had too much success with the passing game up to this point. Blaze brought down for a big loss there, bringing up fourth and a mile. So the Mustangs are going to line up for the punt. It looks like we've got Dante and Jaden back for the return for the
Seahawks. Yep, for the Seahawks, folks. So the Seahawks will get the ball, and they're off. And he got the ball at he's... He did some jukes on the move, and 4th and 10, Seahawks. Good job.
Made it across midfield, brought down at the Mustangs 48-yard line. So it's going to put 1st and 10 on the Mustangs side of the field there. Lining up are the Seahawks in the trips right formation. Jazz is going to drop back. She scrambles right. She moves back over to her left. She's got some pursuit. Ball is up, and it is brought down.
And it's good.
By Lieutenant Dan, who makes a quick move inside and then back outside and is finally brought down at the 30-yard line, bringing up 1st and 10 for the Seahawks from the 30.
Yeah, from the 30-yard line, folks. See, this is going to be a good night for this. Think about it.
So Jazzy making it happen on her feet. She picks up 5 before she is brought down. It's going to bring up 2nd and 5. And the Seahawks are threatening to score once again. Jazzy scrambles to her right, moves back to the left, passes up the middle, and is caught.
Touchdown, if I'm correct.
That is a touchdown. Okay. Lieutenant Dan Chris Taco again with the score. So pending the extra point, the score is now 57-0.
And at my understanding, folks, breaking news, the no mercy rule is not in effect. What does that mean? Okay, clock is going to run down to the end. They're not going to stop the clock. No stoppage of the clock as of whatever. Okay, if it's a penalty, possible stop the clock, only for penalties and reviews. Thank you.
Bob is absolutely right. We are in mercy rule territory, which means that the clock will not stop for any reason except for referee reviews. Blaze takes the ball and is brought down at the 29-yard line. So a good return for the Mustangs. giving them decent field position for this next drive.
Yeah, if they had a new Super Bowl for the NFL, that would be awesome. I know. but we all know that's not going to happen. So, okay, the quarterback did a quarterback sneak. Good job. Okay, unfortunately, you're only second and third right now.
All right, so the Mustangs lined up. Blaze hikes the ball. He scrambles to his right. He moves up and moves back, looking for some room to run. He doesn't quite make it across the line of scrimmage. He's brought down for a loss.
Okay. I'm going to say this.
That's going to result in a penalty there. It looks like the ball was hiked before there was a cadence.
That would be a dead ball penalty. Assessed 5 yards.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what they call, because there's actually two penalties at play there. Offenses are required to let 10 seconds tick off of the play clock before they hike their ball. It looks like the referees are just going to roll the play back.
Yeah. And my mistakes, folks, okay, the play clock, the time will not stop, okay? If it's a penalty or anything, they're still going to run it down to the end. My mistake on this one. Because as well as I said, it's going to stop, it's not going to stop at all. So it's going to run it down since it is the normal Super Bowl.
All right, so Blaze able to connect and convert for a first down. So the Mustangs are going to have first down at the 42-yard line. Blaze hikes the ball, scrambles right. He's got somebody in his face immediately.
Throw the ball!
Makes a move. So he throws the ball. He's listening to Bob, and it is intercepted by Skinner Skytower, who is brought down at the 30-yard line. So another turnover. Killing the Mustangs here, killing any shot of a drive. The Seahawks taking over at the 30-yard line.
Yeah, that's the fifth interception, I think.
As he gets the pass off, it is caught up the middle. Bringing up first and 10 from the Seahawks 42-yard line. The Seahawks wasting no time getting back on the ball. Looks like they want to put some more points on the board here. And the Mustangs, of course, at this point, looks like they're going to go with a screen pass. Pass is thrown to Dante, who then throws it down the field, taking a page out of the Warriors playbook on that one. That's right. That's a Patriots play. That's a what the heck is that play? Seahawks finding success with it, scoring another first down at the Mustangs 38. So first and 10 from the 38. Jazzy hikes the ball. She drops back deep, scrambles to the left. It's got a receiver open.
Good
caught.
Catch. My golly. Good job.
This time Crevin with the reception, it looks like. And he's brought down at the 28-yard line, so first and 10 from the 28 for the Seahawks. And the Seahawks again threatening to score and widen the gap here. Jazzy fakes right, rolls left, crosses the line. She's going to run. She's slowed down and eventually brought down at the 30-yard line. So bringing up second down and 8, it looks like.
Yes, folks, it's second and 8. And she's going again. Hold on. Jazzy's going. She's still running the ball. And it's caught. Wow. Next, no, it's not. Sorry, folks. It's another mistake from my end.
It's all good, Bob. It's been a long day. We're kind of far away from the field, too. So the football doesn't res for me quite that quickly. So it's hard to tell.
Well, you're not the only one, okay? That's a touchdown. Yes, touchdown. No, actually, no, it's not. Sorry. See?
Nope.
Okay. Yes, we are far away from the field. Okay. My guess is your guess too. Okay. Usually we do see the announces of what's going on. Since we can't, our guest is our guest tonight. And she, that's a quarterback sack. But that's second down for the Seahawks. Yes, I got that right, folks. Yep, Seahawks.
Yeah, technically not a sack. She was able to cross the line and gain a yard before she was brought down, but that is going to bring up second and goal. Jazzy's going to show right, scrambles back to the left. She passes to the outside, and it is caught again. This time, Crevin with the touchdown score. So the Seahawks just absolutely dominating tonight. what do I even say to that?
I don't know.
All right. Pending the extra point here, kick is up and good. So with 3 minutes, 37 seconds and counting left to go in the game, the Seahawks are ahead 65 to the Mustangs 0 at this point.
Yep, 65. Yeah. Yep, 65-0. They might be able, if they get another interception, they could get another touchdown and be the same thing as what the Raiders was. 70-0. That was 70-0. But right now, 65-0. So close right now, okay? They're off. And it's caught. I don't know who the player is, to be honest. Sorry. Just that. And it's 4th and 10.
All right, so the Mustangs lining up in a trips left. Blaze scrambles to his left, rolls back to his right. He stumbled and is brought down.
And that's quarterback sack. Okay, only 2 minutes and 25 seconds till 2 minute warning. Yeah, 2 minute warning. Sorry about that. I'm having a brain fart sometimes now for some reason.
All good, and keep in mind, folks, that we are in mercy rules, so the clock will not stop at the two-minute mark. It will continue to tick down. Blaze scrambles to his left, looking downfield for a pass. He's got some pressure.
Yeah.
Gets the pass off, and it is caught. Looked like Kent Voss on the reception on that one, so that is going to bring up
to fourth down.
Third and inches, it looks like. So.
Oh wow. Oh my god. Yeah. You're right. That is 3rd and inches. Looks like it should have been a first down.
Sneak right up the middle there. Blaze picking up the first down and a couple more.
Yeah, folks. That is a couple more downs for the Mustangs. Okay. Right now it's 65-0. Okay. Seahawks in the lead. Sounds like that the Seahawks will get a win tonight, and it will be 10-0 in the standings for the Seahawks. Okay. That means they are the unbeaten team in the AFC. Now, has that ever happened in the league before? A unbeaten team like that?
Yes, it has. The Seahawks last season, went undefeated. They were the Bills, of course, the Mystic Bills, last season. They went undefeated and also, were the United Bowl champions. So, to answer the question, from the audience, yes, they did.
Hold on for one second. Thank you. Dolan. He's going, and that's quarterback sack. Go ahead.
Okay, no, we had a question in the audience about the record. Previously, the Seahawks did drop a game to the Buccaneers. However, the Buccaneers are no longer in the league, and it was determined at that time that all of the Buccaneers' wins would be forfeited. So all of the teams that face the Buccaneers or will face Buccaneers will pick up a win by default.
And I think that the Mustangs are kneeling. That is a good game tonight from the yep. teams.
And that's going to bring us to the end of the game.
This was a fantastic game from both teams. We're going to vote who's the player of the game tonight.
All right. So, what do you think, Bob? Who do you think's player of the game?
Jazzy. Sorry to say, but yeah.
Okay, you think Jazzy? I'm going to go a different route. I think looking at Chris Taco, Lieutenant Dan, number one down there, I think he had a very strong showing on both sides of the field. Certainly Jazzy was very good defensively, so I can see an argument there. So we're actually going to go to our on-the-field correspondent there. I don't think you can hear him, but Greg Stella, who's been a good job at streaming the game here. He's going to actually be our tiebreaker tonight. So
I was leaning more towards number 88 Skinner, or number 88 Lieutenant Dan, which I think is a different one, isn't it?
Yeah, they've got about 18 different lieutenants down there. Okay, so you got three people, three votes. I am actually, with no disrespect to Chris Taco, I'm actually going to go ahead and give Jazzy the nod. You know, I think that on both sides of the ball, you know, at quarterback, she did a fantastic job.
Yeah, she did.
And defensively, she was very dominating. So think Jazzy's going to get my nod tonight.
Yeah. Or we can do this. Usually we don't do this. We can have the fans vote. Okay, fans, this is enough for a sack, okay?
No. We don't.
Yeah,
no.
Sorry,
no,
okay.
No, we're good. We're good. You and I both voted for Jazzy, so Jazzy's going to walk away with the player of the game tonight.
Congratulations tonight, hon. You are the player of the game. Congratulations. We are going to sign off now. My name is
Wait, Bob, before we go, we got to pay the bills here. We've got a couple more sponsors that we want to tell you about before we sign out here real quick. LTD, let me tell you about LTD, Love to Decorate. Love to Decorate is a bi-monthly home and garden magazine, a monthly event, and of course the LTD website, where you can get all information relating to home and garden. We are the number one resource for home and garden. We showcase all the amazing home and garden talent, such as designers, photographers, and stylists. LTD is an Avi Choice winner for Best Home and Garden Website. So that is LTD. Vinyl is inspired by a messy combination of hipster, classic rock, and whimsical imaginings with a dash of geek mixed in. You will find high quality 100% handmade original mesh clothing and accessories for women, men, and unisex styles. That is vinyl. Logolepsy. Logolepsy is a fascination or obsession with words. Logolepsy is bringing your favorite quotes and song lyrics to second life in a new artistic way. Logolepsy also makes posters, flyers, and invitations for your next big event. That is Logolepsy. And finally, VR Sporting Goods. VR Sporting Goods, from custom gloves to standard gloves, face paints, and more. VR Sporting Goods has football gear for your next big game in the UFL. That is VR Sporting Goods. And with that is going to bring us to the end of our sponsors. So once again, congratulations to the Seahawks for a fantastic performance, coming away with the win, moving to 10-0 with a score of 65-0. The Mustangs will move down to 8-2, still solidly in second place in their division, and we look forward to them bouncing back in their next outing. So unless there is anything else, Bob?
Just one more thing, folks. As well, you all right on Facebook, the Rental Circle is back this Saturday. I believe it's at 2 p.m. SOT time, folks.
All right, yeah, make sure you stay tuned in there. That was a shameless plug for Bob, who yesterday won the player of the game. So looking forward to hearing his interview. So with that, it is going to be time for us to sign off. Thank you, everybody in attendance here on the field and those of you in the stream. Join us again next weekend for another weekend of great UFL action. I am Darian Humphreys. That's Bob the Legend White. Good night.
Sound muted.